Father, we thank you and we bless you, Jehovah God. Father, we are grateful. Thank you for your goodness to us. Thank you for bringing us through 2020 into 2021. It is today, the 3rd of January, 2021, our first Sunday service in this new year. Father, we are grateful. Many started 2020 and did not make it. But Father God, you had mercy on us. Your good hand protected us. And you brought us through the horrible, horrible valley of the shadow of death of 2020. And now, Father God, we are in the light of 2021, a new dawn, a new year. Father, thank you for this new season. There's so much to live for. And so we look to you, God of heaven, in this new year. Even as you've spoken to us, Lord, take us hand in hand through every day, every week, every month, through the year, oh God, so that we will live life to the maximum, in abundance, as you have given it to us, fulfilling your destiny for our lives in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus the Christ. We thank you, Father God, for this service this morning, for the things you've already done. Thank you for the prayers, the prophetic declaration, the worship, anointed worship. We are grateful, Father God. Even now, as we come to hear your word, Lord, speak to us, for we shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of your mouth. Our hearts are prepared, our ears are open, Father God, to hear you. God, speak to us now in the name of the Lord Jesus. We thank you and we bless you, for your word will always do us good. Thank you, Father God. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen and amen. Good morning, church. God bless you. And again, Happy New Year. Wow, Happy New Year 2021. It was a dream a few weeks ago, a few months ago. But now we are living the dream of a new year, better year. Knowing what 2020 brought with it, the pandemic, the plague, COVID-19, the damage, the destruction, the hopelessness and the despair that came with it. But we dreamt of a better season, a better year. And that dream has become a reality. So congratulations to you, to me, to you as of my house, and to all of us, Kingdom God, and indeed our friends who are joining us this morning, perhaps now or maybe after the service, through social media, Facebook or YouTube. We bless God for your lives. You made it. We made it. Amen. So grateful to God. Wow. I hope everybody has learned that life is super, super precious. So every waking moment, every day that God gives you, allows you to still breathe in the land of the living, we ought to appreciate God for the day and live life to the glory of God in the name of the Lord Jesus the Christ. My goodness, so many thousands of people died, have gone to the world beyond. Amen. For them, it's over. But thank God that you are here. And so while you are here, thank God that I'm here. While I'm here, let us make our lives count for things that matter for eternity. Let us maintain our prophetic witness as God's people. Let's raise the bar in terms of our faith in God, our service to God, our worship of God. Let's raise the bar, a higher standard. Let's be the people of God that he has called us to be. The holy nation that we are. The peculiar people, the unique people, who only us can give him praise because he's translated from the kingdom of darkness into this marvelous light. So let us be the light that we are, shining brighter and brighter day by day, so that those who see us in our networks, in our circle, in our world, will give our Father in heaven all the glory. Amen. Again, I congratulate you and I bless God for your life. You are here, still breathing, because there's so much to live for. So don't give up on life. Don't give up on your faith in God. Keep living for Jesus Christ. And the Lord will bring to pass that which has promised you in Jesus' name. Amen. So it's Sunday, the 3rd of January, 2021. Remember, by the grace of God, I'm going to be speaking a bit more on our prophetic theme, the word the Lord gave to us as a church, KGC, Kingdom Gospel Church, here where we are located in England. And all our friends, our family members, relatives, you know, sponsors, donors, you know, that are helping us, supporting us. This word as well, by reason of your association with us, it's a word for you. So the very same grace and anointing upon this word, I believe God shall work for you and your house, wherever you are around the world, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you for your partnership, for your sponsorship, and for your friendship. Your relationship with us is very dear. Because of your prayers and your support, we are still doing what God has called us to do in this part of the world. Amen? And indeed around the world as we reach out to other people. So the Lord bless you. And thank you so much for your participation with us through 2020 and the years before. And even now, we hope for a stronger relationship, you know, greater participation as we, as God has given us a new season, 2021, and going forward in Jesus' name. So God bless. So for this morning, 2021, amen, our year of the breakthrough. Our year of the breakthrough. Happy New Year, Kingdom Gospel Church, and friends and family, wherever you are, all over the world. We are the KGC family. Amen. To God be all the glory. We are safely in 2021. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God and to Almighty God who made it possible for us to be here on today. I am so grateful that we all made it safely and very securely and successfully into 2021. Amen. Now that we have put 2020 with all the damage and devastations it brought behind us, we now need to focus on what God will have us do or what God will do for us in 2021. Amen. For that to happen, we must know what God is saying to us or what God has said to us. So what has the Lord said to us? 2021, people of God, is our year of the breakthrough. There's a specific emphasis, the breakthrough, because I believe God is going to do something significant for us as a church. When I mean church, I mean you and I that are in this relationship, this communion we call Kingdom Gospel Church. I believe what God does for the collective is also for the individual. So your breakthrough and my breakthrough becomes the breakthrough of Kingdom Gospel Church. So God is not talking about the building where we're meeting. He's talking about what he's going to do in your life, in your family, in your career, in your education, in your finances, in your health, in your marriage. Amen. In your relationship with your spouse, with your child or your children, in everything that concerns you in your life, God is going to do something significant. So it's your year, my year, and our year of the breakthrough. I don't know what it is. Maybe you've been stuck in a particular area of your life. I don't know what it is. Maybe there's a particular area you've been seeking God for. This year, I believe God, based upon the word he spoke to us, you will experience a major shift going forward as God breaks through for you in Jesus' name. If you could do it, you would have done it by now. But because you cannot, and God who is merciful has seen your struggle, has seen your tears, and has seen your frustration, I believe God that your time has come, my time has come, and us collectively, our time has come for God to, the hand of God, to push us going forward towards our individual and collective destinies in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus the Christ. Hallelujah. So for that to happen, people of God, we must know what God has said and what God is saying. Yes, he said it already. It's our year of the breakthrough. But we need to know, amen, why did God say to us, amen? Why do we need to know, why is God saying this to us? And let me answer you and answer somebody that God does not do anything without his word. Amen. He never does anything. Amos 3:7. God does not do anything except if he first of all reveals it to his servants, the prophets. Amos 3:6 and Amos 3:7. The Old Testament prophet, Amos chapter number 3, reading verses 6 and 7. God does not do anything without first of all revealing to his servants, the prophets. So there's always a prophetic word that precedes. Amen. A word before God does it. Go back to Genesis. Before creation, God will speak, let there be. Amen. And then following his word, amen, whatever he said in his word becomes. That is why I know a lot of people will want to debate it. Do we need a prophetic theme? Do we need to hear from? Yes, we need to hear from God. God does not do anything new without, first of all, giving his word. I will do this. I will revenge. I will repay. I will bless you. I will. God will always send the word. Amen. Before. That is why Genesis chapter number 1, verses 1 to 5. You know the scriptures, it's right there. In John chapter 1, verse 1, the Bible says, the word in the beginning was the word. The word was with God, and the word was God. In the beginning. So God began the beginning with his word. In the beginning, God. In the beginning, the word. In the beginning, God. In the beginning, the word. Amen. So the beginning did not begin God. God began the beginning with his word. And so 2021 began for us with a word from God. The word is, it's your year, my year, our year of the breakthrough. In the beginning was the word. The word was with God and the word was God. So you cannot take God, amen, and his word out of the beginning. So the year did not begin just like that. It began with God giving us the word. That is why we must hear and know what God is saying. That is why for us as a church, we must pray, fast, seek the Lord. Father, what are you saying? And we did spend some time in December of 2020 praying and seeking God for the word. And it's come true to us and it's spoken to us. So where did the word come from? 2 Samuel chapter number 5, verses 17 to 21. Amen. 2 Samuel chapter 5, verse number 17 to 21. Amen. Some of you may have heard this already. I'm sure you have. But listen, the Bible says, amen, we must keep speaking the word. Amen. You know, faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word. It didn't say one time. Amen. It didn't say one time. We need to keep hearing and hearing the word. You know, the faith, Romans 10, 17, faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. So we need to keep hearing and hearing and hearing it, because what you hear, you are able to internalize, personalize, and use for yourself. So in 2 Samuel chapter number 5, verses 17 to 21, here is where we get the theme of the year from, or God gave us the theme from. Amen. It says in 2 Samuel 5, verse number 17, now the Philistines heard that they had anointed David king over Israel. All the Philistines went up to search for David, and David heard of it. Amen. And went down to the stronghold. I pray God, I will always, that God will cause us to hear whatever it is the enemy is planning against us in Jesus' name. And David heard of it. We don't know how he heard of it, but somehow God made him hear about it. And I pray today in 2021 and going forward, whatever it is the enemy is planning, whatever it is, may God anoint our ears, help us to hear whatever the plan of the enemy is, and for us to run to the stronghold, because the name of the Lord is our strong tower, go to him so that he can protect us, he can keep us, he can preserve our lives, and indeed fight for us and give us the victory as he does all the time in Jesus the Christ's name. Amen. Amen. So the Philistines went also went and deployed themselves in the valley of Rephaim. So David inquired of the Lord, saying, shall I go up against the Philistines? Will you deliver them into my hand? Again, so many lessons to learn, people of God. Yes, the enemy may be there. You know you are anointed. David was anointed. A shepherd. He knows. He's not the one that brought down Goliath. He knows about warfare. But he still went to God to ask God. And this is where some of us make the mistake. And I pray in this new year, as we learn from God, we will not make the mistake. It doesn't matter how much you already have. If there's a business opportunity that has come, don't just run into investment. Go and pray. Amen. Listen, not all that glitters is gold. And the enemy will bring fake gold to try and deceive you out of the God-given riches and blessing that you already have. David did not look at his CV that he brought down Goliath. He has the best army as far as all the kings of Judah and Israel were concerned. David's army was, first class, top class army. Oh my God. One of David's army, one of his commanders, lifted up his hand with a sword at war. And by the time he brought his hand down, 800 members of the army of the enemy had been slaughtered. 800, just one hand. Listen, church, David had the best of the armies you can think of. Go read your Bible, read the Old Testament. David's army, no parallel. Well, here he is. Once he heard about the Philistines ganging up against him, deploying themselves, he went to pray. So let us not get to the place where we feel we are so comfortable. We've made it. We know God and then we run ahead of God. No, 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 no. It took prayers and fasting and the word. It took faith to get you to where you are. Whatever it took to get you to where you are right now, that is what it's going to take to keep going, to keep maintaining the victory, to keep maintaining the marriage, to keep maintaining the children, to keep maintaining the church. Whatever is taking you to achieve what you have now is what it's going to take to continue, and even more in Jesus' name. Amen, somebody. And so David went to God. Two questions. Shall I go up? In Jesus' name, somebody's going to go up. We are going to go up in Jesus' name. Will you deliver them to my hand? And I pray that God will deliver, amen, not only the enemies, but your victory into your hand in Jesus' name. And the Lord said to David, go up. And I declare and declare, we shall go up in Jesus' name. Go up in power of God. Go up in the word of God. Go up in our faith in God. Go up in our worship of God. Go up in the word of God. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Go up in our testimonies. Go up to claim and to take more territories for the kingdom of God. In the mighty name of the Lord. Go up in our evangelism. Outreach, winning souls for the kingdom of God. Go up in our prophetic witness as God's people. Wherever we are. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Go up, God said. For I will doubtless deliver the Philistines into your hand. So when you step up and go up, God will give you victory. When you step up and go up, everything that seems to have eluded you, God will bring them to you. So when we step up and go up, God is will do awesome things that we didn't even think he could do for us, or we didn't believe he could do for us, in the name of the Lord Jesus the Christ. Church, it is not about God, it's about us. Are you ready to go up in 2021? Amen. Your prophetic witness, your confession, hallelujah, your faith in God. Are you ready to go up in your hearing God's voice? There are multiple voices speaking to us, but are you ready to maintain that discipline to hear God's voice telling you the way you should go in 2021? Verse number 20. Let me continue reading. So David went up to Baal Perazim, and David defeated them there. And he said, the Lord has broken through my enemies before me, like a breakthrough of water. Wow. Therefore, he called the name of the place Baal Perazim. And they left their images there. Amen. The enemy left his God, his idols. Amen. The carved images, whatever they were. And they left their image, and David and his men carried them away. I believe they went and destroyed them or burned them or used them for firewood somewhere. Amen? In Jerusalem. Church, what is the Lord saying to us this morning? Amen? The enemy went to the valley of Rephaim. But read verse 20. So David went to Baal Perazim. Wow. The enemy was at the valley of Rephaim. But David showed up in Baal Perazim, and there David defeated them. Well, let me explain again some of the things I said on the crossover. The word Rephaim has two meanings, or used in the Hebrew text, in Hebrew literature, in two ways. One way is it's used to poetically describe the spirits of the dead who have departed and who dwell in Sheol, or who dwell in hell. So it's used, you know, poetically to represent the spirits of the departed, the dead, amen, who dwell in Sheol. It's a poetic description of the dead. So here is the enemy now, arraying themselves against David in this valley that is used to describe, amen. In fact, let me just put it, this is about spiritual warfare. It's not at this in this particular use of the word. It's not about the literal. It's about the spiritual, because it's a remembrance, a point of reference to the spirits of the dead that live. Well, it is not human beings that live in Sheol. It is spirits of the dead. So this is talking about proper, strong spiritual warfare. That's number one. Number two, it literally now, really, really, physically, refers to a strong, tall race of people who lived in Canaan. So this second meaning of Ephraim is a literal meaning used to describe an actual people who existed. Ephraim, the word Ephraim, is not a description of a person's ethnicity or race, but rather a characteristic of the people that lived in that area and shared its character. They were basically giants, like the Anakin. The word Ephraim means also terrible ones, and they are described in the Bible as giants and mighty men. So there is the spiritual warfare, Then there's the physical warfare, where we're opposition in the natural. Strong, terrible, horrible, and I'm sure some of us felt a lot of that through 2020 when COVID came with everything it brought. Amen. In fact, the first time we are talking about the refrain or the Raphaites is in Genesis chapter 14, verse number 5. Amen. Remember that battle, King Chedorlaomer and his three kings with him when they defeated the five kings, Sodom, Gomorrah, and the rest of them? So four kings defeated five kings, and the four kings defeated the refrain. Amen. Amen. And along with the Zuzim and the enemy peoples. So these four kings killed the giants, the Rephaites, or the people of Rephaim, along with others, Zumzim and Emim. So they were a people that actually existed. So this is the valley that the Philistines went and positioned themselves against David. But I bless God that David went to where Baal Perazim. And basically, Baal Perazim simply means, listen very carefully, master of breakthroughs. And so the enemy brought both spiritual and physical opposition combined, terrible spiritual and physical against David. But God, who is spirit, who works from the spirit in the natural, before David could throw a spear or a stone, amen, God came and broke through. Amen. So much so that the valley that was supposed to be a place of spiritual warfare and a place of physical warfare became a place of breakthrough. And I believe God that all the warfares, all the struggles, all the opposition of the enemy against you, against your house, against me, against my house, and of course, friends watching us on social media, all of this opposition, both spiritual and both natural, I believe God in 2021, the master of breakthrough is going to break through for you, like David said, it like a breakthrough of water before me. Amen. Before me, which means before me, God in front of me, my good shepherd, doing battle, doing warfare, granting me victory before me, which means David was not even maybe perhaps involved in the battle. All they came to do was gather the spoils and gather the evidence that look at their gods, they've been defeated. Father, we bless your name. What a God we serve. Church. And so here is what God is saying to us, that just as it was with David, so shall it be for you and I, for Kingdom Gospel Church in 2021 going forward, the year of the breakthrough. So this year, be expecting that the master of breakthroughs, he owns breakthroughs. He shall break through for you, break through for me. A lot of you, our friends on watching us on social media, our God, by reason of your association with us, shall break through for you and your house in Jesus' name. What has been that difficulty? What has been that challenge? Where has it been hurting you? There is a God, the master of breakthrough. He shall come through for you, before you, so that like with the Israelites, the Red Sea will be parted so that you will walk through on dry ground to your Canaan in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Baal Perazim, the place is where God gave David the victory. We know where the enemy was. So that place that the enemy meant for your destruction shall become, in Jesus' name, the very same place God will give you victory and give you life and give you promotion and give you increase and favor. Hallelujah. As you go up in God by faith in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Baal Perazim means the master of breakthrough. Amen. The Lord has broken through my enemies before me like a breakthrough of water. Water. Why water? Because out of you shall flow rivers of living water. John chapter 7, verse 37-38. Because the Holy Spirit is shed abroad your heart, but you know the love of God is shed abroad by the Holy Spirit. So the Holy Spirit is in your heart. Therefore, rivers of living water. So God walking with his word by the Holy Spirit shall grant you breakthroughs day by day, week by week, month by month, throughout 2021 and beyond, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God, I'm feeling something about this world. There's so much wanting to come out of me by the Holy Spirit. Listen, I want to encourage somebody. I want to encourage somebody, I want to motivate somebody. There's so much worth living for. So much worth living for. You can't give up now. God brought you to 2020 to 2021. There's a purpose, there's a reason why you are still breathing in the land of the living. May your testimony be better in Jesus' name. May your testimony go higher in Jesus' name. As God breaks through for you in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So what does this mean for us? It means, Church of God, 2021, our year of the breakthrough. It means for us, it's a year of going forward. God told David, go up, go. Amen. And David said, breakthrough before me. So David did not go by himself, for the Lord, his good shepherd, was already in front. So it means for us a year of going forward. It means a year of passage to greatness. Oh, Father, I thank you. I love this word, passage to greatness. You will remember 2021 as the year God did it for you and your house. Your passage to greatness. It means it's a year of possessing our possessions, Church of God. Amen. What is it that the enemy has tried to steal from you or has stolen from you? What is it the enemy has tried to oppose you or obstructed you? But this year and going forward is your year and our year collectively of possessing our possessions. Amen. It's a year of supernatural increase. Amen. Supernatural. This is not just natural, supernatural. Amen. 1 + 1 = 2. But when with the hand of God and the anointing of God, it shall be more than 2 in Jesus' name. Supernatural. You can't explain it. But the only thing you will say that this is God. What does this mean for us, people of God? It's a year of divine restoration. So many of us lost jobs and we lost loved ones, and obviously we cannot bring the dead back to life. Only God can do that for us. Amen. Thank God. May the Lord continue to rest their souls. But I believe God is going to place us in healthy relationships, wholesome relationships, people who will show us love, make us feel important and valid and valuable in the land of the living, so that we don't spend time mourning and in grief and in sadness. Life will be worth living. So it's going to be a year of divine restoration, not just money, not just jobs and all of that, but everything that makes life living worth living. Amen. Particularly the life of God worth living. It's a year of divine restoration. Whatever it is the enemy stole from us, amen, from you, for me and all of us, I believe God is going to cause the enemy to restore it 7 times more in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus the Christ. Church of God, when David saw the victory, I don't think David lifted a sword or threw a stone. Amen. It was a sweatless victory. And I believe God that for us, this year, our year of the breakthrough, it's going to be for us a year of sweatless victory. The only thing we are told is that David came and carried the gods and whatever it is that the Philistines left. We are not told before because the Lord broke through for David. So I believe God that this year, 2021 and beyond, sweatless victory is your portion, my portion, and all of our portion in Jesus' name. And above all, amen, this year, 2021, our year of the breakthrough shall be a year of divine help. Divine help, where God will help us. We are told in 2 Chronicles 26 that God helped Uzziah. He was marvelously able until he became so great. May that be your portion, my portion, our portion in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus the Christ. Church, I could go on and on, but let me just bring it home and say, God has spoken, so we know what the year is to us. Amen. It's the year, amen, of the breakthrough, our year of the breakthrough, meaning our year of going forward, our year of passage to greatness, our year of possessing our possessions, our year of supernatural increase, our year of divine restoration, our year of sweatless victory, our year of divine help. Now, the Lord has said all of this. What should be our response? How should we respond to God? What should we do? Yes, we are excited about the word. Is that all? Listen, it is not just the hearers of the word, but the doers of the word. Uh-oh. James told us in James chapter 1, it is not just the hearers. No. Don't just hear the word. You have to do the word. So what should we be doing? I have put down a few things I believe we should be doing. Number one. We must agree, believe, and begin to confess this prophetic word over our lives. If you do not believe the prophetic word from his messengers, the prophets, how can the word bless you? Remember 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse number 20? Church, number one thing is for us to believe the word of God. Amen? We must believe. Yes, don't just be, and the belief is not just, well, I believe. Well, how do we know that you believe? Do something with the word. Amen? I am married. How do people know that I'm married? They know my wife. They see my wife. There's an evidence, real life evidence. So how do you know? How do we know? It's based on what you do. So number one, amen, we must agree with the word, believe the word, and begin to speak it as our word. This is my year of passage to greatness. This is my year of supernatural increase. This is my year of the breakthrough. This is my year of divine help. This is my year of divine restoration. This is my year of going forward, going upwards. Amen. 2 Chronicles 20, verse number 20. It says, so they rose early in the morning and went out to the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went, Jehoshaphat stood and said, hear me, O Judah, and you inhabitants of Jerusalem. Believe in the Lord your God, and you shall be established. Believe his prophets, and you shall prosper. So, believing in God, you are established. That means you are saved, you're in the kingdom, you're in the church. But you need to believe the prophetic message that his servants, the prophets, bring to you. So your prosperity is tied to you believing the prophetic message of God. And God has sent us a prophetic message, a prophetic word for 2021. It's your year, my year of the breakthrough. And the first thing we do is to believe the word, agree with it, and begin to speak it. Amen? That's the number one thing I suggest we do. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse number 13. What does the Bible read, people of God? And since we have the same spirit of faith, according to what is written, I believe, therefore I spoke. We also believe, and therefore we speak. What do you believe? Well, I believe that 2021 is my year, my family's year, the year for Kingdom Gospel Church, the year of the breakthrough. Do you believe? Well, according to 2 Corinthians 4:13, if you believe, you will speak it. You will decree it and begin to say it over your life. Because you possess what you speak. How? You, with your heart you believe unto righteousness, with your mouth you spoke your you confess your salvation. So you obtain confession, you obtain your salvation by believing, amen, and what? Confessing and speaking what you believe. Remember Romans chapter number 10, verses 8, 9, and 10? You believe, you confess. With your heart you believe unto righteousness, with your mouth confession is made unto salvation. The very same way it started, it's going to continue. I already said it. So we must believe the word of God. We must agree and then begin to confess it. And right through the year, 2021 and beyond, we will be speaking this word in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Remember, it's your year of going up, going forward. Remember, it's your year of divine help. Have you asked God for help? Amen. Church, listen, I'm excited our God is doing. And I hope you share this excitement with me and with us, our friends who are watching us on social media. Number two, what should we be doing, Church of God? I believe we need to attend this word with prayers and fasting. Pray the word into existence. Pray the word into manifestation. That's what I'm saying. So number one, you believe and confess. Number two, we need to pray, attend this prophetic word with prayers and fasting. Pray about it. You know, it's a prophetic word, it's a prophecy. We want it to come to pass. We want it to become flesh and blood. We want it to manifest. Well, pray and fast. Why? Because Philippians chapter 4, 6 and 7, be anxious for nothing. Amen? And I believe, God, that the reason he speaks to us is that the enemy will not bring any anxiety or worry, you know, into our lives so that we can have a clear focus to believe God. Be anxious for nothing, Philippians 4, 6 and 7. But in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Notice it says the peace of God. So the answer, the antidote to anxiety and to worry, is to pray so that God will give you his peace. It's an exchange. where the enemy is trying to bring worry and concern and anxiety and palpitations to your heart. Once you are able to focus and pray and fast and seek God, well, God will exchange and give you his peace. And that peace surpasses all understanding. And that peace will guard your heart and your mind, so that your mind will no longer be troubled. Your heart will not have to palpitate anymore in Jesus' name. So number one, we must agree and confess. Number two, we must begin to pray and seek God so that the world can become flesh. We seem to forget. Amen. Again, John chapter 1. Amen. Verse 1. In the beginning was the Word, was God, and the Word was, and if you read further, they said, and the Word became flesh and dwelt amongst us. That talks about the manifestation of the Word. Look at all around the what you call nature, the sun, the moon, the stars, day and night. It was words spoken by God. Let there be light. Let there be this. Let there be that. And the world became manifested, substance to it, and became what you see today. That same principle applies. God has not changed his ways. And I hope somebody is hearing the voice of God even now as I speak in Jesus' name. Amen. Attend it. The Word can become flesh for you. It can become that which you want it to be. Or you are praying for God for it to be for you. The Word taking on substance. Substance of your promotion, of your breakthrough, of your favor, of your increase. Substance of your healing from that situation. The Word became flesh and dwelt amongst us. May that be your portion as your prophetic word. For that God gave to you, it became flesh and dwelt with you, in your house, among you, in Jesus' name. So that you can touch it, you can feel it, you can hear it, you can smell it, you can taste it, you can sleep in it, ride in it, drive in it, fly in it, whatever it is. Amen. You can live it in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Number three, people of God, we must develop new mindsets and new thinking in line with this prophetic word. We know that 2020 was horrible, but that's history now. I bet you, people of God, there are many who will be remembering 2020 from now till June before they realize that they are in a new year with a new prophetic word from God. So what I'm saying right now, from now, amen, if you've not done it, begin to renew your mind. You are now in 2021. God has given you a new world. You cannot have a year of the breakthrough thinking about 2020 or the challenges. 2020 is old wine and old wine skin. Amen. 2021, new wine skin. Mark chapter 2, verse number 18 to 22. You cannot put new wine in old wine skin. The new wine is too powerful for the old wine skin. It's going to burst and explode. You cannot put a piece of new cloth on an old garment. In fact, the new piece is too strong. It's going to tear, and then the tear is going to be made worse. Read it later. Mark chapter 2, 18 to 22. It's a new year, a new world. So please, new thinking, new mindset, in line with what God has said, not how horrible 2020 is. Yes, it's a reference point. But thank God he brought us through that horrible year. Now we're in a new year with a great world. And this year, the year of the breakthrough. So we need to develop new mindsets, thinking along these lines. And so when the people that want to have the pity party come on their WhatsApp or other social media platforms or on telephone to tell them it's a new year. What has God said for this year? Let's talk about it. For us, God said this. And begin to share with them what God has said to you for your 2021. The year of the breakthrough. The year of going forward. The year of passage to greatness. The year of possessing your possessions. The year of your supernatural increase. The year of divine restoration. The year of sweatless victory. And the year of divine help. Encourage them with what God has said to you is your year. And if they believe it and walk on it, God will do for them what he's also doing for you in Jesus' name. Because God is not partial. All God is looking for is for people to believe him and obey. Amen. Number four, I believe we ought to be spirit-filled. A breakthrough of water. Water. Amen. There are two references in the scripture I'll put in Ephesians 5. Paul talks about how the Lord washes the church with the washing of the water by the word. And Jesus in John tells us, amen, I read it before. John 7, 37 to 38. Amen. He who believes in me shall never thirst. Out of him shall flow rivers of living, out of his heart shall flow rivers of living water. Both of them talk about the Spirit. The washing of water by the word. The word of God is not just physical word in the printed text of your Holy Bible, but the word is Spirit and life. So he's washing his bride, the church, as we preach and teach the word of God, transforming us for the better from the inside to the outside, washing us, cleaning us, cleansing us by the Spirit of the word, so that we can be more and more like him, who is Spirit, Christ-like in every way. I believe we should be more and more Spirit-filled. How? Let me share with you two scripture verses. Ephesians chapter number 5, verse 18, and Jude 1 chapter, verse number 20. Amen. Church, God is saying to step up in a way. He wants to do awesome things. So Ephesians 5, 18, and do not be drunk with wine, in which is dissipation, but be filled with the Spirit, with a capital S. And then if you drop down to Jude chapter 1, verse 20, say, but you, beloved, building yourselves up on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Spirit, praying in tongues. Amen. I know some people, you know, disagree about tongues. And listen, Church of God, if you want to really, really go further in your prayer life, you must employ and engage tongues. Engage God in speaking in tongues. Amen. So, filling up the Holy Spirit. The Word of God, number one, is Spirit. So, we need the Word. And number two, praying in the Holy Spirit. And I testify personally that these two key principles helped my development as a young believer. The Word of God, taking in the Word, studying, not just reading, studying the Bible, looking at dictionaries to understand the meaning of words, looking at other literature to help me understand the book. Amen. And then, of course, praying in the Spirit, praying a lot in tongues, privately, and of course, to a lesser degree, publicly, just not to convince people who do not know what we're about. Amen. More privately than publicly. And well, it's okay to do it publicly. Go for it. But for your personal development privately, a lot of praying in tongues, I will advise and I will recommend. Hallelujah. I must run along. Amen. Time is almost up. So number four is to be, we must be filled in this year, 2021, going forward. It's like a breakthrough of water. It's spiritual, people of God. So it's Spirit calling unto Spirit, deep calling unto deep, as the Bible says. And number five, we must learn, remember, to walk by faith. By faith. You cannot please God if you don't walk by faith. How is he going to work, Pastor? He has spoken to you. You go to work. Amen. You go to work. Some of us want to see the miracle before. No. Whoever gets church, please, we must. The evidence of your believing in God is what you do, and that is faith. Hebrews 11, verse 1 tells us, now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. So really, what you are doing on account of this prophetic word is the faith that God wants to see, that indeed you believe and trust him, that he has told you is your year of the breakthrough. And so you are doing what you are doing for you to enjoy his breakthrough. But a lot of us, some of us will sit back on our backsides and won't do anything, expecting God to part open the heavens and drop the things from. It doesn't work like that. Amen. 2 Corinthians 5, verse number 7. We walk by faith, not by sight. Amen. We walk by faith. But of course, you see, as you walk by faith, we are not blind. Amen. For we walk by faith, not by sight. It is not the natural that drives us, it is spiritual. By faith, we understand the world, the things that are seen are not made of things that are visible, that the visible came out of the invisible. Please go back and refresh your hearts with Hebrews chapter 11. So we must walk by faith. Has God said it? Have you prayed about it? You have a witness of his peace? Then go for it. Amen. Start making the applications. Start developing the business plan. Start preparing for the marriage. Start planning. Start praying. Come on, people of God. That is what God wants to see. The things we do, the substance, amen, to the word that we believe. Number five. Hallelujah. Sorry, that was number five. Number six. I believe we need to depend on the Holy Spirit. Totally. Remember, this is spirit. It's warfare. We need to depend. And how do you depend on the Holy Spirit? Do what David did. Once he heard about the plans of the enemy, the enemy is arraying themselves or positioning themselves for war in the valley of Rephaim. David, he didn't consult his military council. He went to God. Amen. He went to God. Shall I go up? Will you deliver them? He didn't say, will I win? It wasn't about him. Oh, God of heaven, help me here. He didn't say, God, will I win them? Will I do? No. He said, should I go up? At your instruction, I will go up. If not, I'm going to sit back home. Will you? Hallelujah. Amen. Read it again. Will you deliver them? Shall I go up against these Philistines? Will you deliver them into my hand? That is, I don't know how, church, what I'm simply saying, people of God, is that we need to depend on God. Do what David did. Let God know that you're not going anywhere until he says so. And ask, are you going to give me this job? Are you going to do it's him, not you. That shows you depend on him totally. Not on your degrees or your experience. No, not on your name or your pedigree or your clout or the people. No. God is you. Amen. And we have the divine helper with us, the Holy Spirit. John 14, amen, verses 15 and 16 and 26. Amen. John 15, verse number 26, talks about the helper. Amen. All this is possible because we have the helper. John 14, 15 and 16. If you love me, keep my commandments, the Lord says to us. And I will pray the Father, he will give you another helper that he may abide with you forever. Amen. In 26, same chapter, says, but the helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you all things. Teach you all things. All things. All things means all things. Finances, marriage, the ministry, whatever it is. And bring to your remembrance all things I have said to you. That is, the things he said, the word of God. Amen. Chapter 15, verse number 26. But when the helper comes, whom I shall send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth who proceeds from the Father, he will testify of me. Church, we need to depend. Make sure you do. Amen. I intend to. Me and my house. And I believe KGC in Jesus' name. And friends watching us on social media, I hope you are going to be depending on the divine help of God. David said, should I go up? Will you deliver them? I hope we've learned the lesson. Number seven, people of God, we need to be expectant. You need to be patient. God will deliver. He's the year of the breakthrough. Very possible. Some of the breakthrough may not happen until later in the year. Maybe next year, 2022, who knows? But God has said it. Yes, he will deliver. So we need to be expectant, to be patient. God is coming. Remember Habakkuk? Write it down. Wait. Though the vision tarry, will not tarry. When it comes to pass, the vision will speak for itself. Habakkuk chapter 2, verses 2 and 3. So let us learn to wait. And those who wait upon the Lord shall what? Renew their strength, Isaiah 40 tells us. Church, let's be expectant. God has promised. The word, the prophecy is a promise. Amen. A promise is still a promise until it comes to pass. Why is a promise? What do? You wait for the promise. For the promiser, amen, is a promise-keeping God, a covenant-keeping God. It may be delayed, but he will never be denied in Jesus' name. Finally, number eight, amen, I suggest and I ask us to do, that let's start thanking God now for the breakthrough. Not when it has happened. Let's start thanking God. In a way, God is there or obliged. Now we are thanking him even before he performs. And surely your God will perform. In 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 18, it said, in everything, let us give God thanks for. This is the will of God in Christ Jesus for all of us. 1 Thessalonians 5:18. Church, let me repeat it again. What I think we should be, how to respond to God based on this great word is given to us. Number one, we must agree. ABC, agree, believe, and begin to confess this word. ABC of the prophetic theme. Amen. Number two, we must attend the prophetic word with prayer and fasting. That shows you believe. Amen. Number three, we must develop new thinking. Not the pain of the past, not the loss of the past, but the gain that is in front of us, the testimony that is in front of us. Begin to develop a new mindset. Begin to plan your testimony, your praise party, when God brings you the breakthrough. New mindset, new thinking. Number four, be filled with the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God. As we study the word and as we pray in tongues. Amen. Number five, walk by faith. Amen. You believe God, then walk by faith. There are two sides of the coin. One side is belief, the other side is faith. If you have belief, then you must have faith. Because faith without works is dead. Your works, evidence is your belief in God. That is your faith. Number six, we must depend on the Holy Spirit, on the helper. He's given to us to help us. David went to God. Should I go up? Will you deliver them? Not will I win. Let's stop praying. Will I win? Will I get it? Father, will you give me this job? Will you? It's him, not you, not me. Number seven, let's be expectant. Let's be patient. God who has promised will not fail. He will deliver in Jesus' name. Number eight, come on, let's start thanking God for the word and that he will bring it to pass. Amen, that he will not delay. He's a faithful God. Whatever he has said, he will do in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. So I submit to you, people of God, these things I think we should be doing. Maybe those people will tell you to do more. Please feel free to do that. But I think these eight things that we've learned today will help us so that God will bring to pass and make good his promise that this year, 2021, and going forward, will be our year. It's our year. Not will be. It's our year of the breakthrough. And as you have spoken, may that be your portion and my portion. And those of our friends who are watching us and we hear this word on social media, may be our collective portion in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Thank God for your life. Again, I say welcome to 2021 and a very, very happy new year. Your year of the breakthrough. Hallelujah. Amen and amen.